warmth and empathy they show towards charitable causes, their viewers and their deep friendship towards one another are as great achievements as their countless and well-deserved awards. The nation has taken them to their hearts. So many congratulations on the first 25 years of your successful careers and on your very special award tonight. So, Dermot, any ideas as to who it might be?
No idea at all. Do you have any ideas who it is?
There are lads, Ant and Dec.
Come gather round the telly. Come gather round the telly. Now come close. Come closer than that.
Your occupation?
Ooh, what would you call this? I couldn't ask
for another. The hardest thing in show business is to be yourself.
Who is it?
Me!
They are the most famous double act from Newcastle. It wasn't Shearer and Ferdinand, it was Ant and Dec.
They're really, really serious about entertaining people. And it's rubbed off on me.
They're perfectionists. And they keep getting better, which is also really annoying.
We love them.
It's essential that a double act has a wonderful friendship. And they've been constantly together for 25 years.
We've met on Baker Girls.
Declan started first.
Yeah, Declan started first, and then Ant came in.
And that was it. Never looked back.
Hello, Jeff. Easy to drop in.
I was aware of Peege and Deej. I know they exist. I know there was an unfortunate incident with Ant's character. I think the nation have always had a soft spot for them, and I think that soft spot starts there.
And of course, you then became recording stars.
Yes.
You say stars.
Well, we thought it was fantastic. Our son's on Top of the Pops.
Couldn't wait to go and buy the record. We tried to convince everybody else it was good as well.
Well, I thought the music career was over, and then 19 years later, it goes back to number one. I can't explain why.
Anybody that launches that onto the nation and gets away with it clearly has a little gift for something, and that is TV presenting.
SMTV.
Yes!
Was so loved.
Who fancies another game of Splatoon?
And a wonky donkey.
10 seconds, what's that?
Bumblebee!
It's gonna rain!
Bumblebee.
Who is that in the background? Who is that in the background?
No.
Who was it?
Mum!
Mum! Your mum's rubbish as well!
They learnt that just because you're doing kids' telly, it doesn't mean you talk to somebody like a child.
Do you not understand, woman?
Last five is right.
How old are you?
You just talk and you have a laugh, and that's infectious.
Not many make the journey that they make.
Right.
To suddenly be on Saturday night mainstream entertainment playing to millions of people.
This is Dave, Dec,
and this is Ant.
For a number of years,
I think
it was pretty boring on a Saturday night, but when those two came along, Saturday night TV was brilliant.
Fire!
Ant and Dec's lineup of shows is about as strong as it can get. Britain's Got Talent, I'm a Celebrity, Get Me Out of Here, Saturday Night Takeaway.
Are you hurt?
I'm not.
No, no.
But their appeal isn't solely to people of their age, quite the opposite.
They've lasted so long because they've always been very, very respectful of a family audience.
Get on the banana and speak to Danny Minogue.
Danny!
Everything they do has a little twinkle and a spark of naughtiness about it.
I said
I really feel like you're on the edge a lot, but it's going to be okay. That makes them the kings.
I know how seriously they take the business of show. They make it look so easy and so effortless. And it's not.
They work hard.
He's put a pineapple on his head.
They're up really, really early in the morning, which is why they get so mad at me when I turn up so late.
You can make an entertainment show look pretty big these days with huge production values, but you won't get what Ant and Dec bring you.
So I mean, Willie. Ostrich Willie. Yeah?
On the telly.
Which is a sense of humour that everybody can relate to.
Would you do it?
Yeah.
It's almost like when you watch their programmes, they're sat next to you on the sofa and you're watching it together.
Let's find some moms. Should we find some moms? Hands up if you're a mom.
They're just two normal lads. They're not show busy at all. And they've never forgotten their roots.
They love their football. They love Newcastle United.
You run.
Big up.
Whenever the two guys are there, word goes around the stadium.
They're themselves, and that's what comes over. You look at them two on the screen and you think, if I saw you in a pub, you'd be exactly the same.
Cheers!
Toon, toon, Black and White Army, toon, toon, Black and White Army.
I've forgotten how powerful that one was.
Oh, I'm filling up here.
They actually have a genuine friendship. I mean, I find it amazing. I mean, they really do like each other. I've never seen them argue.
I don't think there's been anybody around for many, many years quite like Ant and Dec. You probably have to look back to Morecambe and Wise to find a double act that people hold in such affection.
They are like one life form. Eric and Ernie were like that. Two halves of the whole.
Why don't me and you just play together?
Can we?
Shall we?
Shall we?
Yeah!
Yeah,
come on.
They always know what the other person is thinking.
They are like an old married couple, aren't they? I don't think one would even contemplate going off and doing something on their own.
I'll see you for the next series.
Eric and Ernie only live together in the pretend world of the studios, but Ant and Dec have gone one step further. They live next door to each other.
I'm not surprised it's lasted so long. They are actually a TV phenomenon.
Ant and Dec!
You're on top of the world, you're on top.
They've won 23 National Television Awards.
They've been at it so long, they're only in their 30s, and yet they're kind of veterans of the business.
Declan, you're a genius.
I know that already.
The boys carry on the tradition of amazing Saturday entertainment.
They bring you sunshine.
My favourites. They have a place in all of our hearts.
I think they're going to have a massive, massive, massive future the longer they stay working with me.
They're not lads now, they're grown men, but to us,
we still call them lads.
Yes.
They're still lads. They're still our boys.
25 years in television. I think it's absolutely marvellous. Congratulations. I'd just like to say the next 25 are the hardest.
Thank you for being so well behaved.
Thank you.
Not pops.
Such nice boys.